Hey guys, it's your girl Sisters Getting Fit 123, and I'm here with another hair video, and this is a tutorial on how to rinse your hair or semi color your hair using this jazzing, and the color is ruby red, and it's a rinse. So here's the thing again. What you're going to need to apply your semi-permanent color is you're gonna need some kind of grease for your edges so that the color doesn't stain your edges. You're also going to need a cap so that when the color is sitting on your head, it won't drip and it'll saturate into your hair. You're gonna need a comb to section a part off your hair. And I'm using a brush, but I'm only using a brush because I don't have gloves. But if you have gloves, use the gloves and just use your hands. And I'm going to use these clippies, but the clips are also not necessarily needed. And you're going to need towels or a towel, because rinse, if you get this on anything, it'll stain it and it'll be absolutely impossible to get out of carpet and different types of floors. So you want to make sure that you're very careful with your semi-permanent color. Just to answer a few questions about semi-permanent coloring. When you wash your hair, it usually says 8 times, but in my opinion, it lasts. They last longer. 8 washes. They fade. When I use this, this lasts me like months. but it's not damaging to your hair. And you know what? A lot of people don't like to color their hair after perms. But when you use a rinse are very harmless. So you can use them right after a perm, and they actually come out better if you use it right after you get a perm, because it's easier for it to saturate into your hair than, you know, waiting a week or two. When you get a dye or a bleach, you have to wait 2 weeks, or else your hair turn green, or, you know, it'll fall out, a lot of different things like that. But with rinses, you can get them right away. You don't have to worry about it making your hair fall out. I've been getting rinses since I was in 7th grade, and I'm an adult now, and I've never had a problem with my hair falling out from it. Okay, now let's just get right into it. I shampooed my hair, and the shampoo is out. I didn't condition it. You're going to apply the rinse before you even condition your hair. So, I didn't comb it or anything yet. So, what I'm going to do is I'm going to apply my grease on my base line. I'm gonna also apply it around my ear. Around my other ear. Just so that if the rinse falls, it won't stain my skin. Because it does stain skin. Then I'm gonna do it around the back. Okay. Now that that's done, I'm going to take my comb, and I'm just going to start on this side and work my way up, but doesn't really matter, just as long as you get it all over the hair. And you know, during this video, I might end up not even using the little brush thing that I have and just sucking it up and let my hands get red, but who knows. So I'm putting my towel over my lap so that if it falls, it won't land on the ground. Okay, here's the rinse, and I'm just gonna put it on the hair, not the, can you see that? I'm putting it on the hair and not my scalp, because if you put it in your scalp, it's gonna stain it. And I'm just gonna take my brush and go like this and make sure it gets all over. See that? And I'm actually gonna make another part below this. because I could have went further down and I didn't. So I'm just gonna put another part there and just go over where I missed. There we go. That's much better. Once again, you don't need the clips or anything like that. I only did that just in case I miss a spot. And if it does by any chance stain your skin, you can get it off with alcohol. Alcohol will do the trick. Alcohol or witch hazel or sea breeze or any one of those things. And now I'm going to do this side of it. And you want to get the hair from root to tip. See, I already got it all over my fingers anyway. Through there, and I'm telling you, don't need the brush. You can just use your fingers. It won't make a difference as long as you get it from root to tip. I mean root to end. You'll be fine.
For those of you that think that gospel music has gone too far, you think we've gotten too radical with our message, well, I got news for you. You ain't heard nothing yet, and if you don't know, now you know. Glory, glory. Better put them hands together and act like you know up in here. Chief Pete.
Make the Lord feel something. Ain't no shame in my game, God's property. Getting big with